Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Labs Switches and Multiplexer series. In this video, we will discuss SPI protocol and how to select the right signal switch for a SPI or serial peripheral interface applications. We will start with an overview of SPI, how to solve SPI design challenges with a mux, and discuss the important features to consider when choosing a mux for SPI. These key considerations are voltage, bandwidth, configuration, and protection features. SPI is a synchronous serial interface used by FPGAs and microcontrollers to communicate to a variety of peripherals such as flash memories, sensors, ADCs, and SD cards over short distances. In SPI, typically one main controller is used to communicate with one or more peripheral devices. This figure shows a four-lane, one-to-one, controller-to-peripheral configuration. Here, we see how multiple peripheral devices may be connected to one controller. This configuration may also include multiple chip select lines for each peripheral device from the controller. Configurations with multiple controller devices are also possible. SPI devices are push-pull drivers rather than open drain, so no external pull-up resistors are needed on I/O lines. SPI is not defined by a formal standard, so protocol options may vary by application and devices used. Clock frequencies and data speeds may vary up to 75 to 100 MHz. Typically, the SPI bus contains four channels. Please note that in the terminology used in this video, controller is used to replace the designator master, and peripheral is used to replace the designator slave. The two data lines are typically called and abbreviated as controller out and peripheral in, or COPI, and controller in peripheral out, KIPO. There is also one clock signal channel and an active high-low chip select channel. As mentioned before, SPI protocol allows for direct connections from controllers to multiple peripheral devices. However, adding too many followers to this direct connection will increase bus capacitance and rise and fall time of the signal. Adding a low C-on mux to switch between multiple followers will grant more flexibility in systems with only one chip select line while decreasing bus capacitance. Muxes may be used to select between multiple internal or external memory banks, as shown here. Muxes may also be used to expand chip select output if multiple followers are connected to a leader. In addition, TI has some multiplexers with signal path translation if controller and peripheral devices are not voltage compatible. Analog muxes and signal switches are bidirectional, meaning that the system may drive the signal from either source or drain I/O of the mux, and allowing for additional system design flexibility. Protection switches with powered-off protection may also be used to isolate your FPGA or MCU from non-volatile external memory, simplifying power sequencing even in one-to-one SPI configurations. A switch with powered-off protection ensures that the switch is high impedance when a voltage is applied to the signal while the device is powered off, and protects the switch from damage. The SPI protocol allows for multiple controllers to drive one bus, which may lead to bus contention, where multiple controllers attempt to access the same data line at the same time. This figure shows multi-host bus contention, which may cause bit errors if two different logic values are driven at the same time by two different controllers. On the right, we see how excess current is also drawn. Since SPI is a push-pull driver, if one controller drives a logic high and another drives a logic low, a path is formed from the supply pin to ground. This excess current will drastically increase power consumption, which will increase system noise, and if the current is too large, may permanently damage the devices. Here, we see how bus contention is solved with the use of a mux. Because the SPI bus has no formal or standardized specification, it is important to align your switch parameters with those of the SPI devices in your system. Key parameters to align are voltage, bandwidth, taking into consideration additional factors such as on-capacitance, channel count, and features such as powered-off protection. The supply voltage, signal voltage, and continuous current through the switch must be in compliance with the absolute max ratings of the switch. Most switches support input signals from rail to rail, and some switches even support input voltage beyond supply. Also, be sure that your control signal voltages align with the VIH and VIL of the switch for proper operation. Another key characteristic is bandwidth. SPI does not have a specified max bus capacitance or set clock speed. Therefore, To minimize signal integrity loss, it is advised to pick a mux with a bandwidth that is 1.5 to 3 times the clock speed. The parasitic cion of the mux slows the rising and falling edge of the signal, which leads to some attenuation. Using a mux with a high bandwidth gets a sharper rise and fall edges. Applications with a sensitive signal chain would benefit from a higher bandwidth mux that is 3 times the clock rate, while less sensitive signal chains benefit from a mux with a bandwidth 1.5 times the clock rate. The number of channels is also consideration for SPI multiplexing. For example, a 4-channel 2-to-1 switch may be used to switch between two followers in a typical 4-channel SPI communication. A 6-channel device may be used if more data lines are required, or in QSPI applications. Finally, additional protection may be required in high-performance systems with external non-volatile memory. To simplify power sequencing and protect your system in such use cases, look for a switch with powered-off protection. You can learn more about powered-off protection in the TI Precision Labs training video, Simplify Power Sequencing with Powered-Off Protection. To select a switch for your SPI application, you can search our catalog of analog switches and muxes on TI.com under the Analog Switches and Multiplexers category tab. Our quick search engine helps to find the right switch for you. You can filter by configuration, number of channels, or by using the drop-down arrow on the Features tab to find the right signal switch for your SPI application. For more details on how to use muxes for SPI-based flash memory expansion, check out this application note on the left. For a more general guide on switch selection, take a look at this app note on the right on various design considerations when selecting your muxes and switches. Thank you for watching this TI Precision Labs video. To find more switches and multiplexers, technical resources, and search products, please search ti.com/switches.